Good evening, and welcome parents and guardians, extended family, staff, and graduates to the 2022 Upper Grand District School Board Elementary Remote Program Graduation Ceremony. Thank you for joining us to celebrate the accomplishments of our grade 8 graduating class. Graduation is a time to reflect back on your accomplishments and look ahead to your future. It is the end of a chapter and the beginning of a new one in your book of life. It is hard to believe that this evening marks the end of your elementary school days, but we know you are ready to take on the challenge of grade 9. As you begin your high school career, be sure to set goals for yourself. Envision what you want to achieve and set out a clear path of how you're going to get there. You don't need to think to yourself, I can't do this or I'll never be able to do that. You can do and become whatever you want to do. You are the future of our society, and it is up to you to make your mark and change things for the better. As we say goodbye to you this evening and extend all of our best wishes as you begin your high school journey, I would like to take this opportunity to thank your parents and guardians and families for all of their hard work. It is not easy to raise children, particularly teenagers. You, the families, have been supportive of the school and our staff, and you've been advocating on behalf of your children. Graduates, please remember to thank your parents, guardians, and family tonight for all they have done to support you. I would also like to thank the elementary remote program staff. Your teachers and support staff are remarkable. They are an extremely dedicated group of professionals that I have been very honored to work with for the last few years. All of the staff want you to succeed, and second only to your family, they are your biggest cheerleaders. Graduates, I want to give you something to think about moving forward. Life is all about choices. Make the right ones. Choose the right friends. Listen to that little voice in your head that tells you right from wrong. Be kind, be compassionate, be inclusive, and be grateful for all the people in your lives. I know you will make a difference. Congratulations, Otters. All the best.
Hello, my name is Larea Gilbert and I am in the class of 8A. But before giving my speech, I would like to thank everybody who has helped me while adapting to online learning these past couple of years, but especially my mom, dad, brother, grandparents, aunt, and all of the teachers. Adapting to online learning these past couple of years, especially after being in a physical classroom for 8+ years, was extremely challenging. We all learned very well that we can't wake up 5 minutes before class starts and feel focused during school, or we can't stay in our pajamas all day. We learned that we need to make a good routine so that we can really enjoy school and take out the most of what we're learning. All of the teachers have helped us out tremendously this year. They were right there to answer any question that we had, help with an assignment, or especially this year, with us leaving elementary school and going to secondary, they were right there to answer any questions so that we feel more confident and prepared going to high school. Coming into grade A, I'm sure many people have the goal of being perfect at everything. Get perfect on every test, every question, get perfect on this, that. But I know for me, one thing that I've definitely learned this year is that I can't be perfect. All that I can do is do my best. So going into high school, I have a new goal. I'm going to do my best and be excited about it. So I guess all that I can say for right now is thanks so much, grade 8, had great memories, but here I come high school.
Hi, my name is Brittany Nguyen. Lovely to see all of you. Oh wait, I can't see you. But I bet all of you guys look wonderful. I just want to say that I appreciate each and every one of you, both staff and students. All of you have impacted my life. Even negative or positive, it has made me who I am today. So thank you. All of you have helped me through school ever since COVID. You guys made school more enjoyable and always made me look forward to the next day. I've made some friends during my experience with online school. I'm looking at you guys, Ava and Viv. I appreciate all of you. Being a part of the Elementary Remote Program, aka being an Otter, has been a great honor. Even though I'll be leaving the ERP, each and every one of you will always have a place in my heart. So, thank you to all of you, both staff and students.
Hello, students, teachers, and everybody that has behaved well for the past school year. The class of 2022 graduated from the 8th grade into high school. My name is Yura Aksu, and I'm delighted to be speaking as a graduating 8th grader. I remember always telling my parents how long 8 years is. I know it feels like it will never come. But as being here today, I was indeed way wrong. Yes, during the test, waking up before 9 a.m. for the past 8 years, might have felt like a very long time. But overall, it felt incredibly short. Indeed, I'm very proud and glad to be able to say that we have made some very spectacular friendships, bonds, and memories in those 8 years with some wonderful people. Terrible memories that hopefully will remember for a lifetime. I want to thank all my friends that have been with me this school year. They truly made the school year great, hilarious, pleasurable, joyful, and diverting. The teachers that have had me in their classes, that have made their classes a safe space for us, have heard me say that I felt old for graduating from the 8th grade. My parents, who have been with me all these 8 years, motivating me to keep going and helping me with math on the kitchen table. And lastly, to everybody that has made those 8 years very spectacular and worthwhile, thank you. Thank you for listening, and I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day, as I have had for the past 8 years.
Good evening, teachers, families, peers, and of course my fellow graduates. My name is Ahmed Amhaj, and today seems like the end of a story, a conclusion of the 10 years of work we put at elementary school. However, I see today as the end of a chapter. Before we turn the page, let's take a look at the past 10 years of school. In kindergarten, we had it very easy, playing with toys and listening to books. Then in grade 1, we were introduced to the different subjects, math, science, English, and it was difficult at first. However, we adapted. Through the primary grades, we began taking on more responsibility and had more projects, tests, and the dreaded EQAO. And then when we finished grade 3, we were pushed into a new ballgame, new teachers, new subjects, and new topics. Luckily, through this, we learned independence and time management. Then when we became intermediates, we were hit with many more assignments, tests, and the responsibility of being the leaders of the school. Now, I would like to thank Ms. Petrenko for always pushing us to our limits, Madame Craig for always being positive, Mr. Paquette for always having funny jokes, Ms. Nagel for always understanding and listening, Mr. Glassford for making drama fun online, and I would also like to thank Ms. Hagen for taking the time to look over students' work. Finally, I would like to leave you with a quote from Mark Twain. 20 years from now, you will be more disappointed by the things that you didn't do than by the ones you did do. So throw off the bowlines, sail away from the safe harbor, catch the trade winds in your sails, explore, dream, discover. Thank you.
We all have moments. Moments where we're just on the verge of giving up. Moments where we're just exhausted, and we feel like we should just surrender. But we just need a burst of inspiration. I've had those moments. It's not easy, but if we just fight through and never give up, eventually you will succeed. It doesn't matter the subject, the career, or the country you reside, anything. We all experience it, whether it's on an idea or a project. One second you're absolutely determined to get something done, and a few minutes later, it can all be gone. And you're left wondering, where did it all go? But we need to persevere. If we push through and don't give in to the temptation of a couple minutes of recreation, we can achieve great things. Those great things can turn into even greater things and help everyone out. To the staff, parents, and everyone who helped out with someone's education, thank you for persevering. And to all the students I met throughout the year, thank you for making it through beside me.
One thing I've learned this year is that sitting on your butt all day and staring at a computer screen is boring. But there's some things that help make it worth it. I think most of us have been to a regular school before, where you walk our bus to school, drop off your backpacks at your cubbies, and head to your desk before school starts to talk to your friends. So many people I know that have never been to the ERP say that in-person school is better. But when you think of the ERP, everyone is kind, and all the teachers listen to you, and they give you the help when you need it. So personally, I think online is better. And as we move into high school, it's not going to be like an online school. We're not all going to have the nicest, kindest people in our class. We're not all going to have the most amazing teachers like we did online, because it will be a whole new chapter in our life with new people. But because we were online and exposed to such kind classmates and such amazing teachers, we will get through high school and be the kind people we were taught to be in the ARP. Thank you to all the kind, amazing, thoughtful, and overall legendary teachers and classmates for being the best people ever.
Hello, teachers, friends, guardians, parents, caregivers, and my fellow graduates. My name is Reet Sharma, and I'm from 8A. On this very day, we're about to graduate. Our years of elementary school were beautiful. I cannot wait for what high school would be like. To many of us, this may seem like the ending of a book, though in reality, it is just the first chapter. Our next chapter will be high school, a new beginning and a new thought. Thinking of our last 10 years of our lives, we had a lot of fun, starting with stories and rhymes, all the way to mastering the Pythagorean theorem, making friends each year and having a new teacher, picking class movies to be writing our journals, learning French in such creative ways. Everything had such a great balance. On this day, I would like to remember a great quote by Eleanor Roosevelt. The future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dream. This quote reminds us that anything we can imagine is real, and that the future belongs to us. Lastly, I would like to thank my teachers, parents, caregivers, and administrators. I would also like to thank Mr. Anderson, our principal of the Elementary Remote Program. He has made it so much fun to be online, from our assemblies to the recent Rock, Paper, Scissors Challenge. Thank you to everyone who supported us through this first chapter of our lives. Here is to our 10 years of dedication in elementary school. Happy graduation and congratulations. Thank you.
This year has been yet another hard year due to COVID, but here we are. We made it. Thank you to my teachers and classmates that helped make this year the best possible year that it could be. There were hardships and painful times when it was hard to understand people or you couldn't even join the meetings. But there were also fun times where we played games, did class quizzes, and had questions of the day. So always remember to keep trying and keep pushing through no matter what. Even if the hard times push you down, you have to get back up. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Anderson, teachers and students, for selecting me to give the valedictorian speech. We've all been through hard times these past couple of years, but we managed to push through and stay alive. We made many memories, like when Mr. Anderson wore that Toronto Maple Leaf colored wig, and he painted his face in blue and white, and he even dressed his dog up in a Toronto Maple Leaf jersey. It was really funny. I like the Toronto Maple Leafs, as everybody should. Mr. Paquette told a story when a bird hit his window during class time. Mrs. Miller has a son named Brock, and I thought that was really cool. And she is funny with everything she says. Miss Petranko taught one of my least favorite subjects, English. I learned to push through even if I liked the subject or not. We all go off to different high schools next year. I wish you all the best with your new experiences. Some may be nervous, scared, or even excited, but that's okay. We made it through COVID, so I'm sure you can make it through high school. Work hard, be good, have fun. Thank you. Goodbye.
Hello, my name is Natika. First, I'd like to say welcome to all our parents, guardians, teachers, staff, and graduates. Today, we are at the end of a great milestone, one I'm sure we will look back at during the many years to come. Remote school has been very tough at times, with our internet not always being the most reliable. We've all felt overwhelmed at times. This is something many of us may not have ever imagined. There have been many times where we've doubted ourselves, thinking we're a lot weaker than we are. But throughout the year, we've all learned to be resilient and patient, strong and adaptable, as well as being able to learn and make many new memories along the way. But none of us would have been able to do this without the help of the amazing people around us, and of course, without the ability of believing in ourselves. Our parents, guardians, staff, and teachers have been with us throughout every step, giving us the love and support when we need it the most. They have taught us many things throughout elementary school and have given us many wise words to think upon. Throughout the year, we also got much of our support from each other, helping each other when one needs help. Lastly, by believing in ourselves, we give ourselves motivation. Oftentimes, our brain wants to quit way before we actually can, because we think we can. Overcoming this can be hard, but we all know it's not impossible. I know that if we believe in ourselves, we can, even if success doesn't come right away. Now, I'd like to end off with a short quote by Theodore Roosevelt that I'm sure many of us may have heard before. Believe you can, and you're halfway there. I think this is a great quote for all of us to carry along with us every day and to the next big chapter of our lives. I truly do believe that what you believe, you become. Thank you again to all the people who have made this year a truly memorable one.
Hi, I'm Nathan, and I have personally faced many challenges throughout the course of my elementary years, academically and socially. I'm sure some of you can relate. Among those challenges, I struggle with comprehension, as well as confidence and completing some assignments in an expected time frame. Let's be real here, I'm sure most of you can understand that. So to be standing here today, with all of you, and for all of you, is somewhat compared to touching a distant galaxy far beyond my possible reach. But here I am, and for this moment, I'm not part of that very galaxy. I'm not shining in my mother's eye as she sits here proudly watching this moment unfold. I'm that rapid, strong pulse my father is feeling as he sits here relating to my nerves on edge. I'm that screen that's resisting the release of my sister as she sits here excitedly, each of them supporting me as they always have. I don't remember my first day of school. Today I'll probably remember forever. Maybe I'll forget my first day of high school too. But one thing I'll surely remember, after it's all over, is the support and dedication I've been lucky to receive from my family and at school through support workers and some of the teachers who've understood my struggle without prejudice. I have been a remote learner since remote learning was first initiated. It's been 2 years. I've grown a lot, learned a lot, and achieved a lot more than I ever expected was possible academically. Standing here today is solid proof of how much I've done. This moment gives me hope for my future and for the future of all of you that feel that struggle too. Anything is possible. Don't just be that galaxy. Be the universe. Thank you.
Thank you so much for those fantastic valedictorian videos. It was amazing to watch and super inspirational. At this time, we have some awards that we are going to be presenting. So I will be calling staff to come forward to the front of this virtual stage and present these awards. Up first, we have Mrs. Petrenko with the Language Award.
Thank you, Mr. Anderson. Several students have demonstrated excellence in language arts this year. This includes reading, writing, and oral communication. Congratulations to Harleen in 7-8-D, Ava in 8-A, McKenna in 8-B, Sheikha in 8-B, Eden in A-7-8, and Aaron in F-7-8-A. Well done and congratulations.
Thanks, Mrs. Petrenko. Up next for the Media Award, we have Mrs. Brink.
Thank you, Mr. Anderson. The following student demonstrated high achievement, leadership, enthusiasm, and creativity in media throughout the year. Congratulations to Harleen from 7-8-D. Excellent work.
Thank you. The Math Award is going to be given out by Mr. Paquette.
Thank you, Mr. Anderson. The following award recipients demonstrated high achievement and leadership in math throughout this school year. Congratulations to our winners from 8A, Reet, from 8B, Sheikha, from F78A, Nikita, from 78D, Jasmine. Well done. Congratulations, honors.
Thank you, monsieur. Up next, we have the French Award from Madame Craig.
Okay. Two students really stand out in my mind as having gone way above and beyond the expectations in core French. Seeking out challenges, showing additional engagement with subject material, acting as positive role models by assisting their fellow classmates, and putting their best foot forward during each and every class period. These students consistently demonstrated their amazing effort and always completed quality assignments. They showed boldness and determination when using their microphones to speak in French, and they constantly sought to improve their understanding of the language. Please join me in congratulating Reet from 7A and Ahmed from 8B on their achievement in grade 8 core French. Félicitations les deux et tous les meilleurs en école secondaire.
Okay. Formidable, oh, les élèves! Merci, madame. We have another award from Monsieur Paquette.
Thanks, Mr. Anderson. The winner of this award demonstrates a passion and a love for French language, constantly speaking French in class, demonstrating high achievement in French. And I am pleased to give this award to Nikita from F78A. Good job, Nikita. Well done.
Fantastic. Thanks. Next up, we have Mrs. Nagel to present a few awards.
Hi, it's so good to see everyone. I am so happy to congratulate an incredible student who is getting a science award today. This student has demonstrated such a passion for science. They even created like an apple floating type device. They go above and beyond. When we were talking about water tables, this student took us on a tour of his property to see a water table. So of course, this has to go to Brock in 8A. Congratulations, Brock. Another award I get the pleasure to introduce. Is that okay, Mr. Anderson?
Yeah, carry on. This is great.
Amazing. All right, this award is for history. And this award goes to a student who always asks really great questions that make me go, huh, I have absolutely no idea and I have to look into this. This student is constantly unlearning some biases that they've had. They unlearn, relearn, and learn. They've led some questions of the day. They've participated in questions of the day. This award goes to Ruby from F78A. Congratulations. Félicitations.
Fantastic. Thanks, Mrs. Nagel. Up next, we have Mrs. Hagen for the Geography Award.
Thank you, Mr. Anderson. The Geography Award is presented to a student who has demonstrated passion, enthusiasm, and leadership in geography. This year, I'm pleased to present this award to Reet in 8A. Fantastic. Congratulations, Reet.
Thanks. The next award is from Mrs. Legault for health.
Awesome. Thank you, Mr. Anderson. The Health Award is given to students who show passion, leadership, and commitment to healthy living and learning all year, and also that extends beyond the classroom. So these two students this year really deserve that, and I can imagine where they're going to take it in high school. So for 8A, this award is going to Lorea, and for 8B, this award is going to Brittany. Congratulations. I'm so proud of you both.
Awesome. Thank you. And I think we'll see you again in a bit.
Yes.
Up next is, it's Mrs. Hagen again. Hey.
Thanks again, Mr. Anderson. So I'm also presenting the Physical Education Award tonight. So this award is presented to a student or students who have demonstrated high achievement, passion, and leadership in being physically active this year. So this year, I am proud to present this award to Brock in 8A. And Paige and F78A. Congratulations, you two.
Fantastic. Thanks, Mrs. Hagen. Next, we have Madame Berger presenting the Visual Arts Award.
Perfect, thank you. This Visual Arts Award is being presented to the student who has demonstrated creativity, passion, and dedication in art. Your pieces, your composition, your color choices always impress us and showcase your true talent. Congratulations to Ava in F78A. Good job.
Fantastic. Thanks, madame. Mr. Glassford, I think you have a few awards to present.
Yes, I do. Thank you, Mr. Anderson. So for the Drama Award, the following students have demonstrated enthusiasm and leadership in drama throughout the school year. So in 8A, we have Megan, 8B, we have Natika, and F78A, we have Elijah. In addition to drama, I am also giving out the Dance Award. And with dance, these awards are this award is given to the students who demonstrated high achievement and commitment to both analyzing and performing dance. So with that, we have Duru in 8A, Vivian in 8B, Paige in F78A, and Harlene in 78D. Congratulations to all the winners.
Fantastic. Thanks, Mr. Glassford. Next up, we have Mrs. Petrenko. She's coming back to present the Music Award.
I'm back. Thank you, Mr. Anderson, again. Music looks quite a bit different in online learning than in person. However, three students have stood out as leaders in ERP music classes this year. Congratulations to Lorea from 8A, Ava from 8B, and Ruby from F78A. Terrific job. Thank you and well done.
Thanks. Mrs. Nagel has some special awards to present.
I am so excited to present these awards. Thanks for having me back, Mr. Anderson. How's your day going?
Really well. Yeah, it's been a nice night so far.
That's good. I like how we're all dressed fancy. It's great. It's good. Without further ado, I have to announce these award winners of our ETFO Awards. So the first one is the Elementary Teachers Federation of Ontario Social Activist Award. I'm going to read this because it's too intense not to read. So the ETFO Social Activist Award is presented to a single student who has shown a commitment to making a difference in their world by taking action to help others in need. There was no question who this award was going to go to this year. This student has taken on leadership in pretty much all our assemblies that were participated in by our kindergartens to our grade eights. They single-handedly put together the Earth Day Assembly with some help, but they took on such strong leadership. They've already done such incredible things, and I'm really looking forward to what they continue to do in the future, such as the accessibility assembly next week. So huge congratulations. We know who it is. Congratulations, Natika and 8B. Well-deserved. So proud of you. Amazing. The next award I have the pleasure of giving out is the Elementary Teachers Federation of Ontario Equity and Inclusion Award. I'm going to read this one as well. So this award is presented to a single student who has shown a commitment to promoting inclusion in all aspects of the classroom and who recognizes that equity is a fundamental principle in a school environment and in the community in which we live. We met as an intermediate team to talk about who this could be. And I also met with a bunch of grade sevens and I read this description. I'm like, who would this be? And they all said the same name. This student takes on a lot of leadership, but also knows when to step back and foster leadership in other people. This student has led multiple clubs this year, and they continue to unlearn, relearn new information. Huge, huge congratulations to Nikita from F78A. Yeah, fantastic work. I'd also like to add there were more participants for the Visual Arts Award. So we're very excited too. I know it's so incredible. We're so pumped as well as an intermediate team to give the Visual Arts Awards to Natika in 8B and also McKenna in 8B. Congratulations.
Fantastic. Thanks, Mrs. Nagel. And students, it might have arrived in the mail today, or it'll be arriving tomorrow or the next day, depending on how Canada Post does. But we have mailed out everyone's graduation certificates. And once you receive this very special piece of mail, you're going to open it up and you're going to find a document inside that's going to be a keepsake forever. Also, anyone who received any of the awards that were listed or were announced tonight, it will be noted on your certificate. In addition, there's something called the Otter Honors Award, and this is an award that's given out to any student in grade eight who achieved on their front page of that term two report card for their learning skills if they got E's or G's. So that's excellence or goods in all of the categories. So there's six categories for most of the students. For the asynchronous students, there's only two categories. It is very hard to do some of those learning skills in an asynchronous model, but they can still be considered. And some of those asynchronous students also receive the Otter Honors. So you'll notice you get a special sticker on your graduation certification that shows the Otter Honors Award. So congratulations to everyone. I'd like to turn it over to Mr. Coutu.
Thank you. I first would like to share my appreciation for the amazing staff who, without them, we would not have been able to make this remote program as utterly great as an experience as it was. So, spirit fingers. Again, I would like to congratulate all of the graduates and their families. For many of you, this is the culmination of over 2 years of online learning. Take a deep breath. You made it. This experience came with challenges and it came with success. In the end, this will be but a stepping stone for future accomplishments, both academically and personally. Don't forget your experience and don't forget the memories, but look forward with passion and desire. You've just proven how resilient you really are. You navigated a new version of education, learned or relearned how to achieve success, made mistakes, and were flexible with us as we tried to mute or unmute or share a screen or find an internet connection. You know, some of the fun that comes with online learning. Please take time to relax and enjoy your summer before you embark on your next adventure. Thank you for watching. Congratulations again to the graduating Otters of 2022.
Thanks, Mr. Coutu. That was fantastic. At this time, I would like to invite all of the staff back to say goodbye.
Bye, everyone. Congratulations.
You did it.
Congratulations.
Woo. Listen to
go, Waters.